How's it going, guys? Jeeb here, and Epic has just dropped the V7.01 patch notes, and I'm here to share them with you. The biggest thing in this update is the Infinity Blade sword that you can now find on or at Polar Peak in Battle Royale. It does damage to both players and structures. It doesn't really say here how much, but I'm sure down if I scroll down a little bit more, it'll tell me how much damage it actually does. And then, of course, a big update to creative mode as well. But first, Battle Royale, new LTM, Close Encounters. It's close combat with shotguns and jetpacks. So jetpacks are back in that mode, which is going to be a lot of fun because I really like jetpacks. And it's action-packed because you have shotguns, and shotguns are awesome now. And there's only shotguns in different variants. That's going to be a lot of fun. 15 minutes, typical length, so it's probably like half the time of a normal match. Stats are enabled for this mode. Also pretty nice. All right, here we go. Mythical melee weapon found in Polar Peak. Primary fire delivers a powerful sword slash. It deals big damage to enemies and destroys structures in one blow. 75 to players. It's a really nice pickaxe. Let's see. Alternate fire allows the player to leap great distances. It's upon landing, it delivers damage and knocks up to nearby, and a knock up to nearby players. The wielder sword is also granted additional abilities. Oh wow, 200 shield, 200 health, regen over time. Wow, an instant burst of effective health. It's gonna be scary on the initial drop. Everyone's gonna be going for that thing. That sounds pretty badass. The first player to pull the Infinity Blade from its pedestal will be instantly healed to full health and shields. If a player picks up the Infinity Blade, all other inventory items aside from building will be dropped, so you can only have the blade in your inventory. When the wielder of the blade picks up an item, the Infinity Blade will be dropped, so you can only have the Infinity Blade, basically. Only one Infinity Blade will appear, well, only one blade per match. I can already imagine the game-winning kills with the Infinity Blade. This is going to be awesome. Look at this thing. I wonder how big, like, compared to your player, it's gonna be huge. It's gonna be like, I don't know, it's gonna be like a big greatsword. But creative. There's new fifth island to build on. More, I added a featured rifts. Bunch of cool stuff actually. I saw something down here, prefabs. Yeah, 6 new lucky landing prefabs. Obstacle course. It's gonna be pretty interesting. They got the item spawner, the player checkpoint plate. They're adding a bunch of new things to the creative mode. That's gonna make it a lot. It's gonna make the block interesting once they finally start adding player creations to the block. So I'm really happy that they're doing this. Creative tools plus phone. Added collision options. Collisions can now be turned on and off when moving props. Grid snap is there. Okay, and then some bug fixes here and there. You can now switch to fly while your glider is redeployed. Okay, some basic stuffs here and there. Bug fixes, and I think that's going to be it besides save the world, but it doesn't look like there's a whole lot to begin with anyway, so that's going to really do it for this patch notes, guys. Let me know down in the comments below what you think about the patch notes, and mainly how you think the mythical sword, Infinity Blade, is going to affect the game. I think it's going to be for the better. I think it's going to make it more interesting. Let me know what you think. And don't forget to, of course, leave a like and subscribe one more time, and as always, have a nice day.